Good morning and welcome to worship this morning. Today is All Saints Sunday and we are remembering all the people who are no longer with us, those faithful servants of God who have gone home to their church eternal, to our church eternal. So this is one of my favorite Sundays of the year. It's a sad Sunday. It's a Sunday that brings tears to my eyes, but yet it's a Sunday that brings me joy. So we welcome you this morning. I just have a couple announcements. There is a finance meeting at Homestead tomorrow night at 6 o'clock. And if you're supposed to be there, you know about it. This is just a reminder. The other thing is on November 10th at 6:30 at Grove Avenue, we are having the Charge Conference. And this week, Jennifer and with Stacy's help got our packets put together, so we're ready to go. There'll be some changes, but you know how it is with Charge Conference. So we're glad you're going to be there. And there is Bible study Wednesday night. Pastor Deb will be leading Bible study, and it is at 7 o'clock Wednesday on Zoom. And if you don't have the link, call Jennifer at Grove Avenue, and she will get you the link to make sure you can access it. So we are going to get ready to worship. And our opening, our prelude is For All the Saints. will be a new heaven and a new earth. And so we are waiting for the reign of God. The home of God will be among us. And so we are preparing for the reign of God. God will wipe every tear from our eye. And so we are expecting the reign of God. Death will be no more, crying and pain and sorrow will be no more. But until that day comes, we are waiting. We are preparing. And we are expecting the reign of God to come. So gather our hearts to worship our God, who is eternal and whose love knows no end. Amen and amen. Let us pray. Faithful Redeemer, gracious God, you are the beginning and the end. You promise to wipe away every tear, for death and mourning will be no more. You make your home among us and abide with us as our God. Teach us, Lord, to live as your saints so that we may truly be your people, living and doing your will in the name of Jesus, who is the Christ. Amen. Our first scripture reading today is Psalm 34, and it's verses 1 through 10 and then 22. And today I'm reading from the Common English Bible. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will always be in my mouth. I praise the Lord. Let the suffering listen and rejoice. Magnify the Lord with me. Together, let us lift up his name on high. I sought the Lord and he answered me. He delivered me from all my fears. Those who look at the Lord will shine. Their faces are never ashamed. This suffering person cried out. The Lord listened and saved him from every trouble. On every side, the Lord's messenger protects those who honor God, and he delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. The one who takes refuge in him is truly happy. You who are the Lord's holy ones, honor him, because those who honor him don't lack for anything. Even strong young lions go without and get hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no good things. The Lord saves his servants' lives. All of those who take refuge in him won't be held responsible for anything. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Our opening hymn is, I Was There to Hear Your Morning Cry, sung by Denise Baldwin. And it is a beautiful song. It talks about from the day we are born until the day we die, we are in the presence of God.
To see your life unfold. I was there when you were but a child, with a faith to suit you well. In a blaze of light you wandered off to find where demons dwell. Praise the living Lord, to whom you now belong. join your hearts as one. I'll be there to make your verses rhyme from dusk till rising sun. In the Middle Ages of your life, not too old, no longer young, I'll be there to guide you through the night, complete what I've begun. When the evening gently closes in and you shut your weary eyes, I'll be there as I have always been, with just one more surprise. I was there to hear your morning cry. I'll be there when you are old. I rejoice the day you were baptized to see your life unfold, to see
Our scripture reading today is 1 John chapter 3, verses 1 to 3. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know Him. Beloved, we are God's children. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this, that when He is revealed, we will be like Him, for we will see Him as He is, and all who have this hope purify themselves just as He is pure. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. And our prelude was the For All the Saints. And one verse, you didn't hear the singing, but one verse says, O bless communion, fellowship divine, we feebly struggle, but they in glory shine. Yet all are one in thee, and all are thine. Alleluia, alleluia. Today's a day set aside in the church year to remember the saints. Well, what do we celebrate on All Saints Sunday? We don't celebrate people of superhuman faith or power. We celebrate God's ability to use us, to use flawed people to do divine things. We celebrate everyone whom God has acted upon through baptism, sealing them, as it says in Ephesians, with the mark of the Holy Spirit. We celebrate that God creates faith in us, in God's people, and that through ordinary acts of love, we help to bring about the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven. We bring that kingdom of heaven closer to earth. We celebrate that we have, in all that has gone before us, what Paul calls the great cloud of witnesses, and that the faithful departed, the faithful departed, those who have died, are as much as a part of the body of Christ today as we are. Alleluia. It's quite a thing that we're connected in so many ways to so many people, connected with so much faith, connected through so many stories, connected through so much love. And especially today, in this day of alienation and isolation and difficulty trying to find out where we belong and trying to find a community, we are still connected because we are part of the body of Christ. Well, what connects us to each other? Is it our theology? Our political beliefs, Oh, I know. It's the church the church we belong to, or it's the neighborhood we live in, or it's our musical tastes, or our Facebook groups. None of those things connect us with the body of Christ. And we're not connected by our piety or our works, our good works, or our theological beliefs. What binds us together, what connects us, is our God. A God who just gathers us all up and puts us in the church eternal. So let us remember all those deeply faithful and yet deeply flawed saints of God's church through whom the glory of God has been revealed, is being revealed, and will be revealed. Let us remember Mary Magdalene and Peter the fisherman and Paul the apostle and all the other disciples. And what about St. Francis and John Wesley and Mother Teresa? The list goes on and on of these faithful servants. But today, we remember those that we love who are no longer with us. And so let us remember Gloria Jeffery. Frances Rue, Beverly Dunn, Terry Kuster, Lloyd Hughes, Bill Heiner, Janet Reed, Bud Graham, Anita Meyer, Lori Freenock, John Hickman, let's remember all those in our lives who've journeyed with us, who have lovingly and acceptingly accepted us just as we are. You're invited to lift up the names of your loved ones who have gone to the church triumphant. All of them are now being embraced by God, the God who gave them birth, the God who watched as their life unfolded, and the God who met them when their eyes closed for the final time on this earth. Our hearts are heavy with the loss of dear ones, and we struggle so often to make sense of death. We have so many questions, and there's not easy answers. Why is there so much suffering? But there's meaning. There's meaning to be found. And for me, that meaning is connected to being part of the mystical body of Christ. It means that because death is never final, because in both life and in death, we are connected to God through Jesus Christ and to one another. Somehow God just gathers us up. I love that symbolism, gathering us up into the divine love of Christ and makes us a body both now and in the life to come. There is an inheritance of saints. And even when someday our names will be forgotten, we will always and forever be held in the light of God's glory. For whether we live or whether we die, God is our God, and we are his people. Nothing can break that communion. Nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. Jesus was so full of love when he went to the cross that we, humanity, built for him. Our God in Jesus died, descended into death, as though to say to us, even here, I will find you and I will not let go. Because death has no sting. Death is rendered meaningless to a God of resurrection. And we worship a God of resurrection who is making all things new. Today in our in-person worship services, we are celebrating communion for the first time since COVID. And hallelujah, this is really excitement. It has been a long time since we have come to round the table. But today of all days, is a wonderful day to start serving communion again as we focus on not only those who are gathered in the church building, but as we focus of all of our brothers and sisters of Christ in all times and all places. So even though you who are watching Facebook or YouTube are not receiving the elements, you are will be there with us as we receive the elements. And as we do that, we will also be joined with angels and archangels. And we will be joined with the church on earth and the church in heaven and all, everyone who has ever called on the name of God or will ever call on the name of God. And we are connected to them. We are connected. We are in communion. So today we give thanks for saintly acts done by just ordinary people, just gifts of love, acts of love. And we give thanks for all those who have come before us and handed on the faith and were willing to be used. Used to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. We give thanks for those people who built homes where some form of peace dwelled. We give thanks for people who gave food or are giving food to those who hunger, for those who cared for children, for those who held someone's hand, for those who just reached out and served in the name of Jesus. Oh, bless communion, fellowship divine. We feebly struggle, but they in glory shine. Yet all are one in thee, for all are thine. Alleluia, alleluia, amen. Our joys and concerns, have you put in your joys and concerns? We are going to hear another version for all the saints, and then we will be lifting up our joys and concerns. Ask Oh Lord, we are connected to you. Connected also with the communion of saints. Enter our hearts by your Holy Spirit. Comfort us, strengthen us, encourage us, guide us. Empower us to truly be your people, to be your saints. Fill us from head to toe with your love, a love that just overflows and pours forth from us, a love that touches others and continues to grow. Lord, we thank you for the Church of Jesus Christ and for the fellowship that we share with other believers. But most of all, Lord, we thank you for the gift of your Son, who lived and died and rose again, that we might have eternal life. Today, Lord, as we remember those who are no longer with us, we thank you. We thank you for the gift of their lives and for the comfort of our memories. We pray for those who are alone and for those who are in pain and for those who just need peace in their lives, for those who need a friend to walk beside them. Enable us to be your face in the world, your hands, your feet. We bring before you, merciful God, the names and the conditions that are on our hearts this morning, and we offer them and their needs, these people and their needs, to you in confidence. We pray for the family and friends of Marquita Hetrick, who died yesterday along with her boyfriend and her unborn child in a house fire. We pray for Bev and Seth, and for all those who grieve today and feel the loss. We pray for Eric Stuver and the Taylor family. We also offer to you, generous and gracious Lord, the wonderful things that have happened in our lives. And we praise you for these gifts that you've given us. We praise you for all the saints that we know and have known. We praise you that you empowered us and given us what we need to become saints. We thank you for families and friends who walk with us. We thank you for answered prayer. Lord, in your mercy, you hear our prayers, and we know that. So strengthen us to truly be your people. Touch our hearts with your mercy, for we ask this in the name of Jesus, our risen Lord, and who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. This is a little time of remembrance. Lord, today we remember loved ones who are no longer with us and how they live with you now. We also remember what happiness we shared. Their memory is a blessing forever. Days, months, or even years has passed, and still we feel near to them. Our heart aches for them. Though the grief has softened, a dull pain remains, for the place where they once stood is now empty. The links of life are broken, but we know the links of love cannot break. Their souls are bound with ours forever. We see them now, their faults forgiven, their virtues grown larger. We remember them with gratitude and we bless their names. Their memory is a blessing forever. We remember those who, it seems only yesterday, were part of our life, part of our community. To all who lived with us, we pay tribute. May we prove worthy of carrying on the tradition of faith. Their souls are bound with us forever. We give thanks to you that they now live and reign with you. As a great cloud of witness, they surround us with their blessings and offer you hymns of praise and thanksgiving. They are alive forevermore. Amen and amen. If you are part of the CGH charge, I would ask that you would send your tithe and offerings to one of the churches. If you belong to another church, please send your offering to them. And if you belong to no church, please find a place that is doing God's work in this world and make a donation, a tithe. And God will bless you for that. Our going out hymn is Find Your Wings, and this Denise is singing this also.
It's only for a moment you are mine to hold. Thank you.
as we close out our service today, I just want to say a little bit about historically for All Saints Sunday. This is one of the few holy days that, other than Christmas and Easter, holy days that John Wesley kept in the United Methodist, in the Methodist Church in the United States. So it has a long and rich tradition. And I know everyone who's watching, there have been people in your life that you have loved and lost. And I pray that God can comfort you in this time and bring you peace. So as you leave here today, go boldly and offer the peace and the love that you've been given to others, and do it in the name of Jesus Christ. And know that the God of love and hope and peace is not only with you now, He will be with you forever and ever. Amen. And we close today with Shalom. Of Christ rule in your hearts now and forever. And I have one more prayer request, and that is for Kim's sister and niece. The little niece is home from the hospital, and God is excited to see how her life will unfold, just like He is to see how your life is unfolding. So God bless you all, and have a beautiful week. See you next week. And you are loved.